honor now that I invite back again on stage your chairman and CEO himself, Mr. Roger Barnett, for the final sharing and wrap up. And so without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. Roger Barnett.
Hello, Shaklee family. You know, it's been amazing over the last 2 days to see thousands of people walk across the stage and be recognized for all of their accomplishments. And backstage, there are tables of awards that are more than I've seen at any other national conference for Shaklee. And the most important thing is for every single person who walked across this stage, there have been tens of other people whose lives have been improved because of the Shaklee products and for people sharing Shaklee with them. So thank you so much for helping impact so many people. I wanted to just share a story or a lesson with you from what my father always tried to teach me about business. This is a picture of me and my family. This one's me when I was a little boy. And it's my grandfather, my grandmother, my mother, my father, and my brother. And ever since I was a little boy, my father, who has had a very successful career in business, tried to teach me that the most important thing in business is to try to build for the long term. And when I was younger, I didn't really understand that. I wanted things now, and I wanted them quickly. And I used to say, "Dad, long term is kind of old school. Today you can do it faster and you don't have to wait as long." But my father is a very wise person, and as I got older, I began to fully appreciate that he was right. And so he said to me, "Roger, real wealth is created over the long term." That's a very important concept. So when I was looking for what I wanted to do and build my next business, I tried to find a business that would be able to grow over the long term so that I could benefit not only myself, but other people who were involved in it could benefit from the advice of my father. So I would like to just take a moment and congratulate everybody here, because whether you realize it or not, Shaklee's business, which is the business of providing health and providing income while taking care of our planet, is a business that has the potential to grow for the next 10, 20, 30, 40, and 50 years. So right now, we all have the ability to be in a business that can grow over the long term. That's the good news. The question is, do you realize it? Can we all step back and realize the success that we've had here over the last 3 years, 5 years, is just the beginning of what we can accomplish together? I see over here on my left side, Master Freddie, who was the first master coordinator in Shaklee, Malaysia, 26 years ago. Please stand up. Shaklee was just starting. What if Master Freddie stopped or was only interested in the short term or said, I have to only do something quickly? We would not have seen the benefit of rooms filled with people and people all over Malaysia living healthier lives. So the question is, you have something that has the potential to grow. I encourage you to do Shaklee with all the values of building a long-term business, meaning take care of other people. We heard great stories today, just now, from one of our wonderful masters about how Shaklee has changed his life and his career, and also this morning with a great line that said, if you help other people first, the benefits will come to you. I think that's absolutely true. That's exactly what Dr. Shaklee said nearly 60 years ago. Treat people and take care of them first, and then your business can last for a long period of time. This is a picture of a family in the United States, and they're a family whose lives have been transformed by Shaklee. This beautiful woman on this side with the white hair, her parents started their Shaklee business in 1962. They became a Shaklee master coordinator. Her parents passed their Shaklee business to her. She became the second generation of a family who is a Shaklee master coordinator. She passed the business to her daughter, third generation of the same family who is a Shaklee master coordinator. These two women are her daughter. They became the fourth generation of a family who are Shaklee master coordinators. And this young girl is going to turn 18 years old next year. She will be the fifth generation of one family whose earnings and health have transformed their family for five generations off a business started by her great-great-grandfather in 1962. That is the potential for a long-term business. So when you sit here today, don't just think of what happens next month, or even this year, or even just for yourself. Think of how what you're building can help your children, your grandchildren, your great-grandchildren, and how their lives can take a different direction if you stay at it and work hard every day. I'd like to tell you a story that I think is a good metaphor for the Shaklee business. When I was introduced to Shaklee, I was living in New York City, which is all the way on the East Coast of the United States. My wife and I were both born and raised in New York City. Our family, our friends, our home, our relationships were all there. When I discovered Shaklee, I felt this is something truly extraordinary. It's a business that can compound and grow for decades, but it's a business that makes its money by helping other people live healthier and better lives, and that's such a beautiful idea that I moved with my family, my wife and my children, almost as far as you could possibly go and stay in the United States, from New York City all the way to California, because Shaklee was worth it. And that's the best decision that I have, I think, ever made, certainly in business. So we moved to California in San Francisco, and in the summertime, San Francisco is actually very cold because of the fog that comes in with the Golden Gate Bridge. And I like to be outdoors, and I like warm weather, which is why I love to come to Malaysia, nice and warm, plus warm people. And we decided to try to find a place for our family to spend time on the weekends. And I was able and very fortunate enough to buy this beautiful vineyard up in Napa Valley. And I arrived, and it was beautiful and green, and there were grapes everywhere. And then, like almost everything in my life, I want to invest and do work to make it even better. So, during the summer and the fall, I worked, and we made the vines stronger, and we put nutrients into the soil, and we tied it all better, and it took 9 months of work so that this vineyard would not only be good today, but could produce grapes for many, many years to come. So now it's springtime, and I say to my wife and my children, the vineyard is ready, let's all go up and look at it. And they come in the car, and we drive up, and in my mind, this is the picture of what I was going to see. And I pull up to the driveway, the gates open, and this is what it was. So I called up the vineyard manager, and I said, "What happened? My grapes are dead. They're only twigs, branches with no leaves." And he said, "Roger, have you ever grown grapes before?" And I said, "No, I grew up in New York City, but I always wanted to be a farmer." He goes, "Oh, by the way, to make matters worse, this was my vineyard, and this was my neighbor's vineyard. It had leaves and was already green." And so he said, "Roger, let me give you your first lesson in grapes." He said, "Different grapes blossom at different times." He says, "Your neighbor's grapes are white wine grapes. They're Chardonnay grapes, and they come early in the spring. Your grapes are red wine grapes, Cabernet grapes. They come later." He says, "Don't worry. You have done the work. You have put the nutrients into the soil. You have invested in making your vines strong. You have replanted where they were weak. If you just have patience, it too will blossom and bloom once again." And sure enough, about 8 weeks later, the vineyard returned. So, in many ways, we are in the same position here in Malaysia with Shaklee. The soil in which we operate is very fertile. people in Malaysia want and need to have better health. People here want and need to add to their income and provide a financial future for their family. If you plant your seeds every day, not once a week, not once a month, not once a year, but if you work the soil each and every day, then at some point, the seeds that you plant will reap a harvest. And don't worry. It is not a race. Don't worry if your neighbor's vines blossom earlier than yours, because it's not about what you do in the short term. The real wealth is created over the long term. The soil is good. If you do the work, I believe that you will benefit not just yourself, but also your children and your grandchildren. So, if I can share one thing, we have something very precious here in our hands today. If you look around and see all the people who are part of Shaklee, and realize that despite our success so far, we are really just beginning in a long-term journey. And if you keep at it, and you treat people like you want to be treated yourself, and you always take care of your customer, and you always only make commitments that you keep, then you will get the rewards that you deserve. And I say I'm excited. We are here as your partner. We are investing to support and grow our business. And we have a unique opportunity to help transform the lives of people, but also make a real impact at the national level as well. So I'm just so proud to be part of the Shaklee family. I'm so grateful for all that you do every day, and I look forward to many years of celebrations together. Thank you very much. Terima kasih.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it once again for your